Oh my god, there's birds all over the tree. Please don't poop. Please don't poop on my camera or on me. Oh my god. Anyways, oh my god. Ah. So in today's video, we're going to be talking about how to keep your van cool for upcoming spring and summer of 2018. All different ways you can keep it, your van cool, and then also what we do to keep cool inside our van, to keep Lily cool inside our van, and how it works. So let's just get into it. So you want to do van life, you want to become a van dweller, you already have your van planned out and you know how you're going to build it out. And now you ask yourself a question, well, summer is coming up. How am I going to keep myself cool and how am I going to keep my van cooled on? Well, I'm here to help you and to answer that question for you. As always, before we start this video, I just want to do a huge shout out to all of my patrons out there. Thank you so much for keeping this channel going and for keeping these videos going. I love you guys. I love you all. You're allowing me to spend more time on producing videos and sharing them with you guys and doing how-to videos and trips and tricks and just showing my life. And I really, really appreciate it. So thank you so, so much. And for the rest of you guys, definitely don't forget to hit the like button and subscribe button if you are new to this channel. And don't forget to click the notification bell button so you get notified every single time I upload new videos. And leave me some comments down below. I love reading all of your comments. Even if you just type hello, I would really appreciate it. And yeah, I will probably respond because I like to respond to comments. Not all of them, but still, I like to respond to them. So there's a lot of ways that you can stay cool this upcoming summer. I'm going to be talking about some of them. There's probably a lot more that I don't even know about, but these are the ones that I do know about. Hence, I'm going to be talking about them. So number one is AC units. So you can definitely have an AC unit in your van. A lot of Class B's and RVs already come with AC units, and that's amazing. But ACs do need a lot of power. So in order for you to be able to have an AC, you need to have either one, a generator, which can be very loud, and you need gas for it. And you do need to keep them outside because of the fumes. You know, if you don't want to die, definitely keep your generator outside. And so you need to have a rack in the back somewhere to store it, and you just constantly need to run your generator to power your AC. And it can be kind of, you know, too much, especially if you came with other people. You can't run your AC all night long or all day long because it will irritate other people, so you definitely want to be mindful of that. Another way you can power your AC unit is solar. So like I said, AC units need a lot of power, so you need to have a lot of solar. You need to have a lot of solar panels, and you need to have a lot of batteries because you need a lot of power, and it can get very, very costly very, very quickly. With solar becoming more and more popular and more available, it still can be priced, especially if you need, you know, 1,000 watts of solar, if not more, to power your AC unit. So that's the reason why we don't have an AC unit on our van, is just, you know, it just needs too much power. And with the batteries that you will need to power your AC unit, they take out a lot of space. Even with lithium batteries, the one we have, even though it's pretty small, but we'll need a lot of those to power an AC unit, and they are pretty costly because they are lithium batteries. Another way that you can keep cool in your van or keep your van cool is swim coolers. Those are pretty inexpensive and they work amazing. However, you do need to be in a very, very dry heat for them to work. If you're somewhere humid, they're just not gonna work that well. So that's another way for you to stay cool and keep your van cool is swim cooler. But just like I said, you need to be in a very, very dry heat climate. And one last thing, well, not last thing, how we keep cool in our van is a few different things. So number one, we have a tent. We put a tent on our windows, and it was last summer that we did it, and it's a 3M ceramic tent. It's a little bit more expensive than normal tent, but it does block out, I would say, around 90% of sun heat. So that alone keeps our van a little bit cooler than normal. We have a 5% tint in the back, it's a limo tint, and then we have not as dark of a tint on the side windows up front. I don't remember the percentage of that. And we also have our windshield tinted. It's only 5%, but it does help a lot during the day and during the night. So Definitely consider doing that. Another thing that you can do is make sure you have Reflectix in all of your windows. The Reflectix will black out the sunlight and they will reflect it back. However, you do need to have about half an inch to an inch of space between your window and the Reflectix. If your Reflectix are super close to the window, they're not gonna work as well. They're just gonna pretty much transfer the heat through. But if you have an inch gap, all the heat is gonna stay in that gap. So definitely make sure you have about an inch or so, you know, half an inch to an inch of space between your Reflectix and your windows. And another thing is airflow. Airflow is essential whether you want to stay warm or cool. So what we do is we crack our front windows about an inch to 2 inches every single night, and we keep them cracked all night long, and that will allow air, the cool air, to come from outside in. And then we also have two Max Air roof fans on our van, and we installed them last summer and they've been working amazing and we love it. And what we do is the one that's all the way in the back of the van, right above our bed, we set it to suck air in. So the cold air comes in from the outside and goes right inside the van. And the one in the middle, we set it to suck air out. And so what happens is the air is coming from the front of the van and the back of the van, and it moves all the way to the middle, and the fan that's in the middle of the van sucks air out. The model that we have, it has a thermostat, and so we set it, or because I wake up way before Jed, I will usually just turn the fans on. And then so what we do to don't drain our batteries is we don't run the fans at night because it's nice and cool as it is. And in the morning, if we set the thermostat, the fans will automatically turn on when it hits a certain temperature that we set, let's say 75 degrees. So as soon as it gets to 70 or 75 degrees inside the van, the fans will automatically turn on. Or because I do wake up way before Jed, I will turn the middle one on before I leave, and then Jad will turn the back one on when he wakes up, and it stays nice and cool. We have a nice airflow inside the van. And another thing that we do that helps a lot is our fiberglass rooftop. So before we got the fiberglass rooftop, we had just the metal rooftop, and we had some insulation on it, but not too much. And with metal, it transfers the heat very, very fast. Fiberglass is a great insulation on its own, and it doesn't transfer heat as fast as metal does. So because we have fiberglass rooftop, and we have a bunch of airflow, and we have Reflectix, and we have tent, our van stays nice and cool on the inside up until, I would say, about 11 in the morning, maybe noon. And that if we stay in direct sunlight. If we park in the shade, it stays cooler for even longer. So another thing that you can do to stay warm is to make sure to park in the shade. If you have removable solar panels, that's great because you can always park in the shade and you can move your solar panels out in the sun to charge your house batteries. If you don't have removable solar panels, then you would need to park in the sun to charge your house batteries. Or if you have a battery oscillator, then you can just drive the van to charge your batteries, and that way you can allow yourself to park in the shade to stay cooler. Another thing that you can do is to make sure you have an awning in front of your van. That way you can sit under the awning in the shade and stay cool that way. Or you can even build like a homemade tent type thing for your van. If you cover your van with a little tent or shed, like a homemade tarp shed thingy, then your van is gonna be in the shade, even if there is no trees or anything around you to create shade, and that way your van is gonna stay a little bit cooler. And that way, if you do have removable solar panels, you can just move them just outside of that tent thingy. And another thing that we like to use is those cooling towels. We got a few of them at Walmart. I think they're around $5, and you just soak them in the cold water. And what I like to do is I like to put it in the fridge, so that way they stay super cold and they keep the cold water in there for a super long time. And if you put them around your neck or on your head, it's gonna keep your whole body a lot cooler. And one last thing is water. You have to make sure you stay hydrated. Having enough water with you definitely helps, because when it's super hot outside, you need to stay hydrated. Otherwise, you might die. You might get dehydrated. You might get a heat stroke, and it's no good, especially if you've been dealing by yourself and there's nobody there around you to help you. So those are the things that we like to do to stay cool, and other things that I've seen other people do to stay cool. Let me know down in the comments below if you have any suggestions on how to stay cool in the van, if you have your own methods, how does it work for you. Once again, I love reading all of your comments, so please don't hesitate to leave me some comments down below. definitely don't forget to like this video if you found value in it. And if you haven't become, if you haven't become a part of Even Though Family yet, please click the subscribe button down below, and definitely don't forget to click that bell notification so you get notified every single time I post a new video, which is almost on a daily basis now. Anyways, guys, I really hope you enjoyed this video, and I'll see you guys next time.